Hello, Tom. You didn't listen to me. I'm on vacation. The news will go on fine without me for a week. No, not even a feature. There is no news in Danford. Goodbye. No, Alta's number is unlisted. And I'm not going to answer this one either. I'll see you soon. Yes, I love you too. Bye-bye.
Hi, Jim.
You come back to show off them new wheels?
What you do, overheat? Probably just your thermostat got stuck. Guess maybe I got a habit of talking too much. So, where do you want me to drop you? Look, mister. Maybe it ain't none of my business, but...
Glenn is a lot prettier than I am.
Were you talking to me?
I said Glenn is prettier than me.
God, you are so much better looking than Glenda.
Oh, it's just that my hair, it's...
Your hair is perfect.
I was thinking about cutting it.
That'd be nice.
You don't like it?
God, no. I love your hair. And your eyes and your... cheeks. on your lips.
I just don't want to rush this, Dean.
Me either. And your neck. Your ears.
Dean, this just isn't special to me.
God, it's special. Remember, your parents are coming back tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
Special.
Got you this good in years.
Unbelievable, man. Unbelievable.
I think Glenda is much prettier.
No.
No, don't cut your hair.
Okay, assholes, how long are you guys out there?
I want that door fixed, Ty, and I mean it.
Come on.
Oh, sure, ninja man.
One of these days, your jokes are gonna go a little too far, Ty. And don't eat that pie out there. It's for the Myers open house on Sunday.
Mad dog.
Truly?
God. Put it in the pie. Put in the pie, Myers pie.
Go ahead, man.
Yeah, I was on a roll back there, you know. God, I was so close.
I'm scared shitless, man. You don't hold that couch.
Oh, man, I'm telling you.
Hey. Man, you know, I think it's about time we get Bruce. You know?
Yeah.
Oh, it was his idea.
Is there some beer? We can head over to the mill.
You guys, realize now we're old enough to go to a bar where there's lights, music, action. Girls.
Yeah,
girls.
But no history.
Just go.
Oh, hi.
No, I think I'd rather go to the Thai, get your act together seminar by Alex B. Young, Anchorwoman.
Alex is back in town?
Thai, man, I think. Look, take your sister's seminar, man. She's hot.
Hi, Dean.
Ooh. Oh, a little jealousy, huh?
Need your bag,
bud. Ow! Whoa! Chip Patrol.
Oh. I want that door fixed, Thai.
Later.
Jerks.
Go on later, baby.
Thanks for the pie.
Well. If it isn't Alexandra Young. Still here, Beth? You got your teeth capped. Yeah. Would it be too much to ask for a cup of coffee? Not at all. Will that be Colombian or French roast? Anything, even instant, will be fine. And some cream.
Right now, I'll tire her.
You know, every time I use one of these things, I feel like it's puking in my coffee. Better that and then this one, I suppose, huh? I really need this vacation. So how you been? You really look good. Are you working out every day?
Yeah.
You're blushing.
Someday.
Since when did you become so bashful? Well, I'm just glad to see you. Also thought it'd be a good idea if we spent some time alone together. You know, brother, sister stuff. Oh, remind me, I need to bring her something back. What's good?
Get her the frog legs. She loves them.
Frog legs? Frog legs, frog legs. She's for $13.95. You'd think they'd give you the whole frog, pond and all.
Is everything okay, Al?
Yeah, why?
I mean, how come you're home? Last week you called and you told us that you were gonna start the nightly newscast at 6, and you were starting some new radio talk show. What's going on?
I want to tell you, I really do. I'm just not sure you'd understand. I'm not sure I understand. I mean, everything's going well, it really is. It seems like it's happening so fast.
Ready to order?
Nothing.
You're not eating?
I already had some pie.
Okay, I'll have the number 12.
How would you like your steak?
Rare. And an order of frog legs to go.
Something to drink?
The coffee's fine.
So you're getting the job if you want. That's the problem?
It's a nice problem to have. I mean, it's a chance of a lifetime. But it's a 3-year contract. You always have to be on. I can't even wake up with junk in my eyes. If I want to have a baby, I only get 6 weeks off. I'm not sure I'm ready for that kind of a commitment.
You sound like you're being drafted, Al.
Well, see, that's the thing. You work for years to get somewhere. Suddenly it happens. And you're afraid to move. It's crazy. No, I'm crazy. Tell me I'm not crazy.
You are crazy. But listen, I'd get comfortable with the idea. I mean, imagine somebody else getting the job, not you.
I don't want to lose it. I really don't.
Don't force a decision. It'll come. Just relax.
It sounds like procrastination. Putting off the inevitable.
Okay, have it your way. I'll be right back.
Person I expected to see here tonight. According to Alta, you're on your way to the top of the network.
Well, you know Alta, she still thinks Elvis is alive.
Don't you?
I'll leave you two alone. Al, I'll see you back at Roach Motel. Adam?
You know, your brother's really turning out to be quite a gentleman.
I'm on break, Trace.
No, I don't know who I dislike more, that punk kid.
Or the man who took your job.
Yeah, well, that's what re-elections are for, aren't they?
You know, it looks to me like you could lose some weight. That chip on your shoulder looks like it weighs about 10 pounds.
I imagine you have a lot of activities to cover in the city. Crime, politics. Accidents?
Don't tell me Danford's void of activity.
Oh, no. Last week we had some real excitement here. You remember Richie, Mrs. Harrington's fox terrier?
Yeah.
Well, every day he rides into town with her to pick up the mail. Turns out the dog is epileptic and has a seizure on the front seat of the car. She panics, loses control, and smashes into a power pole. Powers out for hours. When the paramedics arrive, she's covered in blood, has a gouge over her head, but she insisted they look at the dog first.
Was the dog hurt?
No, actually, the dog was fine. 2 days later, though, it choked on a dog biscuit and died. I guess nobody knew the Heimlich maneuver.
Well, poor Mrs. Harrington, she must be at least 90.
Yeah, and so was poor little Richie in dog years.
Is this for real?
Yeah. You're gonna be in town for a while, right? I'll catch up with you a little later.
Area kept sterile.
Gary Bateman found the body about an hour and a half ago.
Where is she? Gary?
Just give me a minute.
Yeah, you take as much time as you need.
Just give me a minute.
It's all right. Just a few questions and we can get you home, okay? Did you see anyone either coming or going?
I didn't.
Did you touch the dumpster?
No.
You said you discovered the body about 1.5 hours ago.
Yes, I did.
Okay.
Send an ambulance to 1025 Lambert Way.
Look, I'm convinced the body was dumped. There's no blood leading to or from the dumpster, and his head is full of glass. I'm going to start the post right away. I've already called Dave, and we'll work all night if we have to. Hopefully we can give you a specific determination first thing in the morning. Is that okay?
Mm-hmm. That would be great. What do you think?
I don't even like to speculate on ones like this. I can't even tell at this point how long he's been dead.
Why not?
Because of the mutilation. Rigor mortis is no good, and in this heat, decomposition starts immediately. I'm hoping to get an approximate time from a liver tip.
Robert, see if there are any prints, tire tracks. Check all around the bin for footprints and see if anyone knows or saw anything. Earl, right now I want you to patrol as far north as the county line. Call me if you see anything.
Jesus Christ.
This is a tough one. I don't know what we're going to do about it, quite frankly. Bothered about all these people standing by. Oh, here they are. Here they come.
Oh, no!
This may not be news in L.A. I run a motel and your brother maintains it, but at least we know the value of a relationship.
Adam and I are ancient history.
Well, that's what reporters and archaeologists are for.
What?
Digging up the past.
Oh, Alta, I came home to find out answers. I mean, to figure out what I want to do.
And he's part of the equation.
I swear, one of these days, you're going to drive me crazy.
One little lobster in the itty-bitty pool.
Hello, Gene.
Hey, Alta.
Alex. This is Jean Grabowski. Jean, this is my goddaughter.
I know you. De-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de-de. This is the Nightly News with Alexandra Young.
That's good.
You can have room 25 tonight, Jean.
Beautiful, honey, beautiful. Look, by the way, I got something for you here. Let me see, where the heck is this? Oh, here it is. How about this? the Squint Scraper. It'll make your driving safe and smooth. No kidding.
A Squint Scraper?
Yeah, I bet you can't say that 10 times in a row.
Well, probably not.
look here. I got something for you.
Squint Scraper.
How about this for your desk, huh? Look. That's neat. Yeah, and tie here. Now, here's an item to talk about. Look at that, see? Hey, and if you ever want fish, I'm talking fresh fish, you call that number. We got representatives all over the place. Yeah, I got some more in the car.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night. Spitting contest. Spitting contest.
Okay, buddy. Let's see who wins.
All right, my turn.
Aha!
Dog.
I win, buddy.
Hey, got the stereo?
Oh, I forgot it, man. But we got our own. Ready?
To rap. My name's Dean. Whoa, watch that, man.
Watch you behind, man.
Shit.
I can't see a damn thing. Man, this place gets better looking every day.
Probably because we have Lily Munster as our maid.
Watch out.
Shh.
Come on,
sweet home. I'm sorry.
Maybe Julie called the cops after Ty for breaking the door down.
Yeah, Bruce, you know that must be it. Something's wrong, man. Something's not right. Something is definitely wrong.
I'd say all three murders were committed by the same person or persons. All of the victims were mutilated in exactly the same way. There are definite signs of an animal attack. I've got our odontologist on it right now, making casts of the bite marks found on all of the bodies. The couple that Earl found in the trunk, I estimate to have been dead for 2, possibly even 3 days. We'll know more by this afternoon.
You said a couple?
Yes, I would say a man and a woman in their early 50s. The woman's head is missing, making identification very difficult. Especially if they're transient.
I've never seen anything like it. It's only 7:30 and half the town knows about it.
behind the restaurant.
Yeah, he is. Sheriff, Mayor's on the phone, line two.
Press conference. Who called it in? Wait a minute. How did you get this number? Alta's number's unlisted. You called every motel in the area.
Damn it, Tom. You promised me a week. There are three network affiliates in this area. Why can't one of... When? How many?
Already had 30 calls this morning, talked to four or five different television reporters and three newspapers. I don't see that we have a choice. I think we have to contain this thing before it escalates into mass hysteria.
How are we gonna do that?
I've scheduled a press conference for 11 o'clock this morning at the courthouse. You'll have a statement prepared, full of assurance that every possible thing is being done to apprehend this maniac by our office and the state and local police. I want you to avoid any description of the victims or the circumstances surrounding their death. And most important, reinforce the support of the community to stop this thing.
Will do.
Adam. I don't have to remind you that this is an election year. Both of us.
Yeah.
Now, leave that alone. I've got the whole day planned. First, we're gonna clean up this mess and catch up. Then we're going to go into town so I can show you off, and they got a great... Why not?
That was the station that called this morning. I have to go to an emergency press conference. There were three murders last night.
Oh, then you have to go back to L.A.?
No, the murders happened here, in Danforth.
Here?
Danforth.
Do they know who? Then I guess we better get you fed. Would you go get your brother and knock on Gene's door? See if he can leave those crustaceans long enough to come get a bite. Last night?
Yeah, Julie called about three times.
Who's Julie?
It's Dean's girlfriend.
Well, who was that girl in the restaurant last night?
What girl?
The girl that threw herself at your feet when you walked through the door.
What is it, a slow news day in L.A.?
What viewers really want to know is what's going on with you and Super Gob.
Al, come on.
I know. When I find out, they'll be the third to know, after Betty Crocker and me. Speaking of Betty Crocker, you should see. She's making enough food to feed an army. What is this?
What? I can get dressed myself, Al.
Looks like you got dressed in the dark.
Thanks.
Come on, let's go do breakfast, shall we?
Move it!
Rapunzel, let down your long hair.
Chasing after you guys down to the mill. I mean, it's eerie enough during the day. My parents, they're not coming back till tomorrow now. I'm gonna be here all by myself tonight.
Not necessarily.
Well, this sure isn't the way I would have handled things if I was the sheriff.
But then again, you're not the sheriff, are you?
Testing 1-2, 1-2. Let me go first and begin by offering my sympathy and support for Marie Riley and her family. Jim will be deeply missed. Francis?
At this hour, we have 3 bodies, all Caucasian, 2 males, 1 female. The patterns of mutilation suggest one perpetrator. The first victim has been identified as James Calvin Riley. His body was discovered late yesterday afternoon in a garbage dumpster 2 miles south of Damford on the Mountain View Highway. We estimated the time of death to be approximately 5 p.m. The other 2 victims were discovered this morning at 4:30 a.m. in the trunk of an abandoned car on the same highway by a sheriff's deputy. Both victims were killed at the same time, and we placed their deaths somewhere around 8 Monday morning. As of now, we have not identified either body.
This is for the coroner. When you say mutilated...
I'm sorry. I can't go into that right now, as investigation is still ongoing.
This is for the sheriff. Do you have any suspects yet?
There's a good chance these killings were random. There is no evidence to indicate premeditation. We are continuing to examine the dumpster for clues and to comb the immediate area for further information.
What are you doing to make sure this doesn't happen to somebody else?
We are beefing up our patrols, and we have asked the state police for assistance. We are also bringing in additional reserve officers from Hume County. In the meantime, we suggest, if you live alone, find someone to stay with. Children should be attended to at all times. Your home should be secured both night and day. And if you see or hear anything out of the ordinary, don't be afraid to report it. We will determine its significance.
We want more protection.
Yeah. All right, now there's a good chance, since these murders occurred on the main highway, the killer is long gone. What we don't want or need is a public panic. We don't want people accidentally shooting their neighbors. Your cooperation in this matter is vital if we're going to apprehend this killer.
You know, I followed Jim Riley on my way into town last night. I tracked him and waved at him. And I'm sure it was around 4:30.
All right, let's wait and talk about it inside.
I could use a good stiff drink. How about you?
Yeah, why do
you want to go? I don't know. Anywhere you want.
Adam, in the mood they're in, I'm more frightened of that crowd than I am that killer.
Excuse me, ladies.
Are you checking up on me?
What? How are you going to snare him? Take him to lunch.
Listen up. I don't give a damn about your aspirations. As long as you work under me, I want unity and allegiance. You got that? Now go find out when those reserves are coming in.
Don't let this one get away. Remember. I'll see you back at the hotel.
What? So how about lunch?
Well, no time for that, but how about a cold drink?
Okay. They're all really frightened.
Mm-hmm.
Are you listening to me?
Mm-hmm.
You're a million miles away.
Uh-huh. You know, they all want answers, and we don't have any.
Is Is there any relationship between the victims?
Well, that's the first thing we check.
How about patterns? Any possible patterns?
Hey, I thought you were on vacation.
Good morning, Virginia.
Good morning, Alta.
That was an emergency city council meeting. That was a joke. It's not safe to walk the streets because the sheriff's having his coffee and he's getting the paycheck, right? But the deputies, they're so abused. Well, the reason they're not telling us anything, because they don't know anything.
And they won't. Later, Wally.
Excuse me, Wally. You're out of the cherry-flavored cough drops here.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll get those for you next week.
And by the way, Wally, if you'd stop trying to run the sheriff's department, you could take better care of things around here.
Sugar, right?
Yeah, you remember. Are you following me?
Of course.
Coffee black. When you get a chance, swing by. I can give you a more detailed report.
Sure. How about an hour?
Listen, Adam, for what it's worth, this is a difficult situation. I've been through this before. We had a mass murder in San Benito, and the whole town was ready to hang the police department because they couldn't come up with answers. People without answers demand accountability. So get ready to put on the hot seat. Listen, if you need any help, just give me a call. I can't remember when I've seen anything this grisly. Tag along?
I thought you were on vacation.
Come on, get up!
Meet an old friend. Alex, meet Francis Stern. Brandon, say hello to Alex Young.
Hello. Ah, he looks kind of beat. You better make sure he eats. Well, he's kind of dumb. He'd forget to sleep, too, if you didn't watch him.
Now, hold it. Your medical opinion is one I hope I never need.
Then what are you here for? What'd I tell you? Come look at this. I found something kind of strange.
Looks like a hair.
That hair is identical to those that we've found in the wounds of all the other three victims. And that is not a human hair. Those bite marks we've identified as belonging to a very large, I mean very large, dog, or possibly even a wolf.
You're saying an animal is responsible for all three deaths?
I hope not. I mean, what kind of animal would throw its prey into a garbage dumpster and then take off in a truck? Much less put bodies into the trunk of a car. Now, I think what we're dealing with here is a person who owns an animal with a real ugly disposition.
And a long leash.
That help?
Definitely. I'll get some more men back out there. This time we're looking for Cujo. Thanks.
You know?
About it being an animal?
No, about you looking beat. I'm taking you home.
Oh, it could have been a lot worse. Thank heavens it wasn't that new TV in room 7. Come on. Now hold still.
Hurt.
I'm almost done. There, you're good as new.
You're great, you know. Thanks.
Plenty of sunshine through today.
It's time for Craig the Banker.
Maintenance.
What's that smell? God.
guy's deranged. Let's get out of here.
Well, not anything I can think of. The drain's a little slow.
That's what it was.
Draining, yeah. I mean. Yeah. It takes its own sweet time.
I'll take care of it for you, okay?
Yeah. My name's Gene Krabelski.
Hi, Bruce Anderson. Dean Lesher.
Dean, Bruce, hi.
Okay.
Hi. I gotta take care of these little guys, huh?
I'm thinking.
Oh, they're getting life. They got life to them. Hey, how's it coming in there?
I'll take care of it.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Oh boy, look what I found. Dad Nats, Mr. Limpla. This is nice.
Oh, hey guys, that was the greatest promotion we ever had. Nothing ever topped it. You know that?
Must be Pisces.
But I'll show you something new we got here. Let me see. Oh, here it is. Look at this, the squid scraper.
Nice.
How about that, huh?
What is that?
I got something else to show you guys. It's gonna make algae eaters obsolete. You know what algae eaters are?
Yeah.
Huh?
Watch.
Look. Sit down, I'll show you. Look, see this? Oh. See this frog here? On the other side, there's a cloth that has an abrasive little material on it.
So
it won't scratch the glass.
Oh, okay.
Watch. It goes like...
Mr. Krabelski, what is that?
No, Krabelski. Gene Krabelski. Call me Gene.
I'm sorry, Gene.
Now look, see this magnet on there has a, like a little cloth with an abrasive on it.
Ooh.
It just takes the algae right off the glass without hurting the glass.
Wow.
See, without
nice.
Scratching it.
Oh, it's motor powered, huh, Gene?
Oh, yeah, elbow grease. It's all off. Yeah, look, watch this. It even goes around the corners. Look, and it won't. And the magnet won't give away. Look, see that? Oh boy, it flipped right over. See how it works?
That today? Bad idea.
What is it?
Guys, looks like good reading.
Well, that's a good idea.
Let's aggravate a guy that leaves rotten meat in his drawer as an air freshener.
Listen. When the day and night are equal, and the Dane shall sing the epithalium, bloodlines will transverse, intersecting, and the resulting metamorphosis will parallel the equinox. I am the Dane, and I have come for you.
Bloodlines transverse. I am the Dane. I have come for you. What is that?
This guy's a nut.
Get dictionary. Look up this word. Epithalium. Starts with an E.
How do you spell it, man?
E-P-I-T-H-A-L-A-I-U-M.
Right there.
Yeah, it says here, it's a nuptial song.
This guy's a nut.
This is a crazy homicidal maniac here.
Give me the diary and bring it back.
No chance. Guys, I'm gonna sing Julie my epithalium.
Come on.
It's not a good idea, man.
Guys, I'll meet you in the mill in a few hours, okay? BYOB.
You wanna ride?
No, I'll walk, I'll get there a lot faster. Seeing you drive, bud.
Thanks.
Lighten up, buddy. Come on, don't worry.
You got a knot right here.
Ow.
Don't talk with your mouth full.
I felt it.
Knock it off.
You're a law man. You're no stranger to pain.
Hey, I'm sorry. You've got a bad attitude. You're gonna need some behavioral modification. I'm gonna have to punish you.
Oh, yeah? How?
Did I tell you about Mrs. Harrington's Nubian coat, Max?
No, not that.
It seems that she was loading him into her minivan.
I'm not listening. I've learned my lesson.
Hey, you were great today.
I didn't do much.
I've never felt so inadequate. How can you expect people to believe in you when you don't even trust yourself? These people are terrified. And I don't know if tomorrow Moore will be dead. I needed the support. It's funny you came along just when I needed you.
This plague did seem to follow me, though, didn't it? You know, I passed Jim Riley on the road the night I came home.
And?
I don't know. I don't know. You know, it's natural for you to doubt yourself. But I know you. You understand their fear. You'll deal with the pressure and still do your job.
Hello? Yes. Yes. I see. Yes, thank you. Good night. That was the coroner. They've identified the bodies. They're both from L.A.
He's white, but he can play ball. It looks like it. Oh, 3-point distance. No good. Okay, recess is over. That was the last bell. Lesher. He's at the plate. He's looking good.
Played in Spanish ball for a year before the pros. He just couldn't pick up the language. 3-2 count. He calls timeout. He's pointing to left field for his mom, who's sick in the hospital. He's going to hit it for her. 3-2. That's it. That's strike three. Oh, sorry, Mama. The crowd. Guys?
Todd, Bruce! Guys!
Guys? See you guys! Got a pipe. Use it, man.
Check for any signs of animals.
Sally's full of stray dogs.
Well, I'm just looking for one. Just give me prints, give me hairs, ticks if you have them.
Why would you
just
want
do it?
He said that Dean was on his way back to Julie's house and that he left alone.
Bruce offered him a ride. Should have come home with him.
He said something about a book back at the motel in a room.
Bruce. Nice fix up. Wait till Dean sees this thing. That's hot.
So, Ty, where's all the stuff? Where's the bedroll and the rotted meat? Where's the journal?
Journal. Dean had it with him when he left. Still must be on him.
We searched the body, sir. There was no sign of a book.
And you and Anderson were the last people to see Lesher alive.
Oh, you're a moron.
What'd you say?
In case you didn't understand me, the only person around here that's guilty of committing a crime is you. For impersonating an officer.
Miss Celebrity thinks
that you're an asshole.
Hey, I don't have to take
Earl,
that kind
of... Go make yourself useful. Check the other rooms and see what you can find. Robert, ask Alter to bring a register down here. Let's find out who had this room last.
Boy, you're really something. It's not enough that your therapy program drags him off into the streets to watch one of his friends get scraped up. But now you have to persecute him with the assistance of that Neanderthal that you call a deputy?
No one's persecuting anyone.
When I think of the things I said to you earlier, that you do your job, you want to know what's even more unforgivable? Is that while you're standing here acting like a cop, somebody else is out there probably getting killed.
Now look.
Don't touch me.
Nobody's accusing anyone of anything. Ty was the last one to see Dean alive. We just have some questions.
Here's
Sam. The mill.
Yeah.
The what? Okay.
Thanks. Who said something about the mill?
Yeah, we gotta go see him. What do you know about some bikers? Did you have a confrontation with some biker?
What are you talking about?
They just found one of them mutilated outside of town. His friends are testifying right now that Ty put a knife into his leg less than 4 hours ago.
What's going on?
Alta, who was the last person to rent this room?
Well, it hasn't been rented for a month. The thermostat is broken.
Well... These would do a real nice number on someone. Slice them up pretty good. Huh, Ty?
I'm getting sick. I gotta get out of here.
I'll just keep you company.
What are they doing?
Down court, finds Jabbar, hook shot, 2 points, baby.
Thank you.
funny.
Damn, Mel. I can't see a thing.
Cuff yourself to the car. Now! Or I take back a corpse. Just what the hell did you think you were doing? Did it ever occur to you that if your friend's in trouble, maybe, just maybe, I could help? This is crazy. We're all trying to stop these murders. And I'm not here to fight you.
Stop!
Asshole.
Anderson! Anderson, come on out.
Alex, where are you going? Alex. Alex, what are you doing? Alex.
Here, it's a nuptial song. I am the Dane.